Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents, we're doing this a little bit different. You can't see the screen, but I can. What you have up here is a small little area that this particular screen recorder allows me to record in. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play a telephone call. Now, this will benefit many of you because this is going to let you know that if you follow the process and if you are determined and if you stick to your guns and don't allow the general responses you get back from these idiots to sway you, that things can work out. This is regarding a recent, I mean, not last year, this year, $23,000 discharge of an automobile payment. Well, the balance of the automobile that the individual has only had for less than 2 years. Okay? $23,000 from a $26,000. Well, he said that he purchased it for $26,000, but he owed about $23,000 when you get all the interest and the fact that they were accumulating charges and so on and so forth, where all of that is taken care of. Now, mind you, I'm also playing this because there's a lot of you guys think that I got a lot of time. So the reason why we have this little window up here is because this is going to be playing in the background. You're going to have to adjust your volume because I got this all the way up. Now let's turn it down. You ain't got to adjust your volume. I'll adjust it here. This way you'll be able to hear it comfortably. But the other way it'll be loud, and so you just have to want to have no problem hearing it. It's going to start off with Maxwell. He sings a song, Symphony Unknown. And so that's my ringtone now for a couple of months. And then I'll, or weeks or days or whatever, whenever I feel like changing it, I'll change it. But at the beginning, you're going to hear me tell him it's about time. Why? Because he called me the other day, then called me back. Then I called him. We've been playing phone tag. And he said he had something to tell me. Well, now you're going to hear what he had to tell me. I have people telling me, leaving me messages talking about, oh, how they got something important to tell me. And then when I talk to them, all they want to do is ask me questions about process and how to take care of something they already done. Notice how this individual doesn't do it one time. Notice how he doesn't ask me, how does he do this and how does he do that? How he says, well, I'm just going to do this and I'm going to do that and I'm going to do this. He says what he's going to do without asking me, what do you think I should do next? Okay? Because I get tired of that. I am not your cushion to come and sit and lay your head on talking about, can you tell me how to live my life and tell me how what my next step should be and then what I should eat for dinner and oh God, can you tell me how to talk and what my next words would be? I'm tired of people asking me for advice on every single thing on this planet. Stop it, because you're not going to get an answer. Trust me, ask the people who try and see how they haven't got an answer. Had one guy told me that he had the parts that I was missing, the secrets about the infinite state, called me, told me he had this. And then when I talked to him, I'm telling him how to handle his stuff, but he ain't told me now one thing. Pay attention. Now one thing about what he claimed that he was contacting me for. And I haven't spoke to him since. He's tried to call me at least 6 times, trying to get more information, and he won't get any more information from me because I don't like being played. So people, stop it. And yes, I gave him a little bit of information, but I gave him just enough to make sure he understood that he wasn't going to get nothing else and that with the little bit I gave him, it was only enough to get started. Sorry, not enough gas to get to the gas station, just enough gas to get you off the highway so that you'll be out of danger, but not enough gas to get to that gas station. I'm not going to do that, y'all. Y'all not going to rob me of my extra fuel to take care of y'all business. So without any further ado, because that's 17 minutes of me telling y'all everything that's going on, let's play the call. Took you long enough.
Hey, man, I told you.
I'm sorry. Okay. I used to smoke that stuff too. I know what that junk can do to you.
Okay, I know. So it's all right. I understand.
Okay, as long as you understand.
Okay, if there ain't nothing else on this planet I know how to do, it's to understand.
Okay. Yes, you do. And you do it well.
I feel for you.
And you explain well. And so I just called to give you a praise report, a good testimony, man, of, you know, things I learned from you. And I had another vehicle, my Infiniti. So through the administrative process.
You got an Infiniti? Infiniti. An
I-30. Okay. The I-30?
Yep.
Is that like a coupe or just a...
No,
Four-door, okay.
Sedan, sunroof, electric,
well,
everything.
And you don't have to use the music because you use your iPhone or whatever.
You better believe it. You better believe it. I don't even know what a radio is anymore.
Good deal for you. So what I did is, and I'm going to go back, I'm going to take you back to some of your initial money orders or it's probably back in 2012. So
it has to be 2012 because I haven't really done much after that.
Right. So I sent them, and it's funny because I didn't do it on any bond paper or
you don't have to.
Check paper. I just did it on a regular 8x11. Okay, and put all the pertinent information in there, and with the letter because I did the. I asked them for a payoff balance and all that kind of stuff. And so I sent it to them. They sent me back everything that I sent them, the originals, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she enclosed, we're returning your payment and correspondence for these reasons marked below. And the reasons just says, please send in regular money order or check, right?
Mm-hmm.
So they didn't give me any deficiencies or defects or anything in that nature. So I hadn't gotten to the tender payment information yet in terms of bringing that to their attention. So the next one I sent them a Treasury direct item bill of exchange. This is your improved one, okay? Now this one is on the document that has security features in the paper and stuff. So I got a money order, Unicitrel, and all that information with a reference offer acceptance pledge beneficiary. Okay.
So you don't have to explain everything to the man who did the process.
I'm just trying to make sure
because it seems like you're trying to tell me how to do the process.
I am not.
Really trying to understand why are you trying to tell me how to do something that I didn't tell you how to do, and you told me at the beginning of the call that you were doing it based on what I told you how to do. So,
what you're listening to is he was doing all that explaining to me. To help me understand what he was doing when he originally said that he followed my process. So he's telling me how to do the process that he was doing as if I needed to know all of that stuff, wasting my time. Told him I didn't have a lot of time. That's why he laughed, and because he sees how ridiculous it is. But watch how we're going to have that same conversation again. And I said, y'all been listening to me for 17 minutes. Y'all wasn't listening to me no stupid 17 minutes. This call is 17 minutes. Y'all only been on this call 8 minutes. Hold on now.
My mind is sitting up here going, what the? You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I do understand.
Okay, so I sent them, the second correspondence was sending them, I think, this. And it actually was a notice of default, final conditional acceptance offer, remedy, settlement, adjustment, set off, and discharge. Sure.
Talking to my God out loud, and I said, Jehovah, you and your son told us to put up with one another, but this putting up with one another isn't as easy as y'all made it seem. Okay, that's why you're laughing.
Say hello, man. I apologize. I had to put you on hold. I had another call come in.
Okay. Go ahead, put me on hold.
Lord have mercy. My bad.
Okay.
I apologize.
So, okay, so she sent me all that back, right? So the next one was, I sent an affidavit. Let's see, the notice of violation of debt, notice of violation of debt, discharge of debt affidavit. I sent that. And then I sent the, because she didn't respond to that, and I said, it's been over 120 days since I sent you this notice and you received this affidavit, you have failed to respond. So this one I sent, an affidavit, notice of legal action, intent to sue. So, they then responded, say, well, you know, I'll also send within the Eon one of those closed checking account checks. Okay, I sent them two. So all in all, I think I sent them about five negotiable instruments, right? And of course, I got all this.
I got you.
Yeah. Oh, anyway, so then they try to still, you know, work it out. Say, well, we can resume payments and stuff. I said no. So then they sent a letter for repossession. So in this letter that I put affidavit, notice of legal action, and intent to sue, you forfeited, you know, any alleged rights because you have not proven validation. So when they sent that, then someone put a card in my door, a repossession company. So I got, you know, fear jumped on me, right?
Did you get afraid?
Yeah, I got a fear jumped on me. I'm being honest with you. You know, I'm a trash
man. I don't know why.
So, come on, man. I'm telling you. So, I parked my car around the block, you know, in the neighborhood. Yeah, man. So then I said, you know, the Lord told me, he said, hey, they're not going to come and get this vehicle. And besides, before they did all this, before they sent the repossession, the Lord said, they're not going to come and get this. They're not going to get this. So I said, okay. But then I was tested. When the repossession guy came and dropped his card off, fear jumped on me. And so I was doing all that. And I said, you know what? The Lord told me they're not going to get it. I'm going to stand in that word. I'm trying to park my car in front of the house and everything. New Year's come, you know, and I'm still parking my car. And next thing I know, this was last week, I go through Credit Karma. And they send you notices and stuff. And I saw, just in brief, you know, said something about your credit scores went up 54 points. I said, what? How? 54 points? So, mind you, in my mind, I was ready. I was in the process of probably trying to get a default judgment, okay, with all the information I have. I didn't put it together yet, but I started thinking in my mind I had to overcut. Anyway, so I looked down on my email, and I see 54 points go up. I said, what is this about? I look in there, man. And it reads in my credit on CarMax, you have paid 100% of this, what is it, debt or whatever, this account, zero balance, highest amount, $25,000. And then I look, this can't be true. And I'm looking at it, and so I looked at other information, compared it, and it said, dispute, did it say dispute settled? Customer disagree. Yeah, I think it said something like that.
That's
dispute settled in there.
Claim with the credit bureaus.
Yeah, well, did I do that?
You must have, because you filed a dispute. That's why they said dispute settled.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you filed a dispute.
I don't remember doing it. No, quite honestly.
I'm going to ask you what you remember. Did you hear me say, do you remember filing a dispute? I know for a fact that you did not hear me ask you, do you remember?
Okay, man.
Lord have mercy. See, Jehovah,
So what I did, man, I said, okay, Lord, you know, you're going to give me a blessing. And so I compared other credit that I had, like automobiles, where, like, one of them I had, it's past 7 years. And it says zero balance and whatever, highest debt. And then it says, hard to collect, something about debt, hard to collect the debt or whatever, delinquent debt, and those are my, and there was another one I thought, I said, wow, okay, so this thing is paid off, you know. Hey, let me tell you also what I did.
You didn't answer my question. I said, how much was the total amount? Oh, you think I got all day.
Oh, put out, you don't. $25,000 This is about $25,000
The total amount for paying off that car was $25,000, right?
Yeah, it was $25,891.86.
And after you paid the $25,000, or after you paid all whatever you paid up to this day, they were coming at you to get the whole car?
They just put a repossession thing in there.
My question to him was regarding the fact if it was $25,000 and it's on an Infiniti that he had, I didn't know how long he had the car, so I assumed he only had the car for probably 10, 11 years, $25,000, and he only owed a couple more payments on it. So I assumed he'd already made years worth of payments, and that's why you're going to hear me say the next part.
No one came.
Yeah, but they were coming for the whole car, even though you had made payments all this time.
No, no. Hear what I'm saying. I did it through this administrative process. This,
no, no, you're not listening to me. When did you purchase the car? When did you first get the car?
Oh, I see what you said. Yeah.
Now you understand. So why you got me repeating myself? Do you see, Jehovah, this is what I'm talking about.
April 7, 2016.
Lord have mercy.
No, I think there was something like that.
You owe on the car when you first gave them their money orders? What was the one that you owed?
Hold on. It may have been 23-something.
Okay, so you just got rid of a $23,000 debt because you figured, oh, what the hey? I ain't got nothing better to do, so I'm going to do it this way. Did I say that about right?
I was influenced by you.
You, I'm going to try this because I ain't got nothing better to do. I can't afford to be paying any fools.
It was my belief and understanding that they were paid initially when we signed the promissory note. Okay, and how can we continue to do this? And so as I continued to research and as best I could and understood, I applied what I understood and believed that I would be able to have this discharged in that manner. Okay. My first vehicle that I tried, it didn't happen.
I'm going to do this so that you do all right.
Okay.
It is two puffs and then you pass. Okay. You're going to cause yourself a lot of trouble by being selfish and stingy and greedy. It's called gluttony. So you can't be consuming all of it to yourself. Okay?
I'm not.
Ladies and gentlemen, I told him I was going to give him some advice. The advice was it's two puffs, puff, puff, and pass. Told him because he is sitting up there trying to consume it all by himself and keep it to himself, that's being greedy, that's gluttony, and that's being selfish. Told him he's going to cause himself a lot of problems, so that's why he's laughing, just in case y'all didn't hear it.
All right. So, and it's not you're following what I said, because I only gave you guys the laws. But you have no idea the amount of people that are continuing to call me and tell me this and tell me that. As a matter of fact, I'm going to take this recording and put it, because you ain't said your name, I'm going to take this recording and I'm going to put it on the net so that everybody and their grandmama can hear what you did, and so that everybody and their grandmama can understand what I go through in these calls for people calling me.
I want the world to know.
I want everybody and their grandfather to understand this is what we put him through, and we wonder why he gets upset and mad and yelling at the computer screen and playing music in the background to relax himself. So don't say nothing else. Don't say no names or nothing, because I'm going to play this for the world to hear. Because they don't know, because as I told you, I'm busy working on a lady's motion for her court case, but thank you for the information so that everybody else can hear what you did, okay, and how you tried to explain the process to me.
Okay? Now, y'all know what I was trying to do. Y'all know
Now you want to sit up there and correct the record. Mm-hmm. That's okay. You can sit up here and try to backpedal and clean things up all you want, because they already know who I am. I got my piece out.
Yeah, he got
they not
going
to listen to you, because you already told them you did all this because you listened to me. Mm-hmm. And they heard me talking to Jordan.
Hey,
you said God told you they ain't coming after that car. Well, God should have warned you in advance of calling me how this conversation was going to go. Oh, don't get choked up now. Okay?
This conversation is going exactly how I want it to. You're hilarious.
Oh, this is how you wanted the conversation to go. Okay, so the next time you call me, I just get to send you to file 13.
No, it can't do that, man.
No, because I got to give you what you want. The rule is give the people what they want.
That's not what I want. I don't want
that. That is exactly what you told me you wanted. You wanted me to do that.
That's just what's going on. Floor 13 in the building.
I'm going to give you your full faith, and I'm going to give you your credit.
Hey, man, you the man, dog. I'm serious.
I'm the man sitting next to the man that called that a mother. Okay? That's who I am.
Shut your mouth.
Robin Harris was a genius. All right. So let me let you go, because I do have to finish this lady's paperwork, because I've been distracted, and because I've been answering the phone, it's been causing the motions not to be harmonized. So I'm going to have to.
All right. Well, I appreciate you, brother. I appreciate you.
Well, there you go. You got to pay off $23,000.
So yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now I'm going to continue to share with people as I learn. So go in peace, brother.
All you did was got rid of a government obligation, and there could have been ways for you to do it a whole lot smoother, but you just got rid of a government obligation. All right.
Hey, I got that. I'm glad you. Ooh, man, you the man. I'm telling you. Go on, do your thing, man.
I already know. You ain't got to tell me. I don't know why you keep trying to tell me stuff that I already know.
Lord, I know you the smartest. You the smartest man you know.
You better believe I am. I am GA. Okay.
Hey. Man, go do the motion, man.
I said GA, I mean AG, IMAG. I'm a genius. Okay?
This is so laughing.
IMAG. Okay? So,
all right, man. Yes, sir. Take care, brother.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was an unscripted, unpracticed, unprepared conversation. But as you heard, all he did was he did the process that we told all of you to do. You simply send them a payment. Doesn't matter whether they accept it or not. We've already showed you the laws that says it doesn't matter whether they consider it to be a proper payment or not. They don't get to determine that. It's a government obligation. They are to take it to the Treasury and discharge it. If they refuse, then you send proof that you've sent a payment to them, and you challenge them, and you do exactly what he did. If you want to know how to do it, go back and listen to what he said he did, and then follow the steps. He got rid of $23,000. As he said, his credit score bumped up by 54 points as a result of this. Okay? That's how he knew that it was cleared. He didn't get a letter in the mail or nothing, but that's how he knew it was cleared. And because he didn't give in or give up and add all of that dumb language that so many other people add in. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, 25 minutes worth of telling you how somebody paid off a debt. Have a good day. Oh, and you're welcome.